Alright, so in this tutorial, we're just going to be going over some path menu items that we can do to these shapes. So I'm going to go ahead and select the shape, and this is the stuff that we're going to be talking about today, which is the split path, reverse path, object to path, and close path. So the first one that we'll talk about here is the split path. And in order to use that, you're going to use your tool that's right up here called the shape tool. And I'm going to go ahead and click that. Now once you do that, you'll see that nodes pop up right away. And for example, with the split path, you need to select two nodes in order to split. So I'm just going to go ahead and split this in half. So I'm going to hold the shift button down while I'm clicking. So I click that first node, then I got the shift button held down, and I click the second button. And then I can go up to path, split path. And as you can see, the black color has gone away. That's scale letting you know that, hey, these are now open paths, and you can see that I can separate them. So that's the split path. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to object to path. All right, so object to path, just wanted to show you a quick example on this. What object to path will do, it will take that object and it will create it to a path. So I have the circle here, and I'm going to go ahead and copy it, and I'm going to go ahead and paste it real quick. So I'm going to go ahead and copy, and then I'm going to go ahead and paste. All right, let me drag that over here. All right, so I have two circles here, and I'm going to convert both of them to a lattice effect. So I'm going to go ahead and right-click here. I'm going to go to Appearance, Lattice, and I'm just going to hit OK. And then I'm going to go ahead over here, do the same thing, right-click, go to Appearance, Lattice, and hit OK. All right, so I have two lattice effects that are the exact same thing. And what I'm going to do to one of them is I'm just going to go ahead and grow it. Okay, and then I'm going to, on the second one over here, I'm going to go to path, object to path, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to grow it. All right, so you see the difference here? The object to path, it actually resized the whole thing. When I did not do the object to path, it resized the oval, but it recalculated the lattice effect automatically. So that's one way of using that object to path works. Now this works with rhinestones as well as the lattice. All right, so the next thing is over here, the text. So if I select the text over here and I go to the shape tool, you'll notice that I don't get any nodes, but if I select the football helmet, I do get nodes. So another way for object to path to work is I like to convert this text to a path. And as you can see, if I scroll down over here from my properties window, that I can still modify this text. So once I have the touchdown selected, and if I go to path, and if I go to object to path, you'll notice that the properties window, I will no longer have that option to convert any of that text or edit that text. So once you convert it to a path, you are now stuck with the text being a path. So that's another way to use object to path. So you may ask yourself, why would I want to convert text to a path? Well, basically, if you use your shape tool over here, you would be able to actually modify these nodes on the text. So that would be one reason why you'd want to convert your text to a path. But then again, you lose the ability to use your text tool over here in order to edit the text. Alright, so moving to the next item is the closed path, and I'm going to go ahead and choose that tab here. And what I have here is a pumpkin that I've split in half already. And what closed path will do, it will actually take the line right here, and it will close the path to the line over here. All you have to do is select the shape, you go up here to path, and go to closed path, and as you can see, it closed that path. So that's what closed path will do. It will take the two endpoints and it will close them off. Alright, so next on the list is the reverse path, and basically this will take the start point of the nodes and it will actually like reverse the path. And a way that you would probably want to use this is, for example, putting text around a circle. You know, so I'm going to go ahead and put a circle on here, and I'm going to add another circle so we can use it later. Alright, so let me go ahead and make this big. So right, so I have two circles about the same size, and I'm going to go ahead and make this one blue, just so we can see the difference here. All right, so the white circle over here, I'm going to leave normal. And the blue, I'm going to go ahead and go to path, and I'm going to go ahead and reverse the path. All right, so check this out. I'm going to go ahead and use the text, and I'm going to go ahead to type text on path. And as you can see, it typed on the top. So if I go over here, we'll see what it does. It gives you a different outcome. You can also use the flip buttons to give your text different positions to start, whether it's on the bottom or top of the line. So that'd be a way to use reverse path in Shortcuts Lot 3. All right, so I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you do, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. We always come out with new videos, and you'll be the first to know once they come out if you subscribe to our channel. It's free. What do you have to lose? With that, I'm Rob with ScrappyDude.com, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.